Hello, welcome, and good evening. And tonight we wanna finish up our Let's Code on the SoundBlaster PCM playback. Last time we learned how to do the single cycle playback, which means that we programmed the PC's DMA controller to supply the SoundBlaster card with PCM data, so waveforms that you can play, digitized sound to be precise. And we could play one DMA buffer full of sound, which, well, depending on the size of the DMA buffer, if it's something like 32 kilobytes, will amount to about 3 seconds worth of audio at 11 kilohertz sampling rate. Well, this is of course not much, and sometimes you want to have like continuous speech or music playing back, and for that we need to switch to something slightly different. The single cycle playback is not good enough for that. Okay, so let's enhance this program. So first of all, before I forget that, we will change the file name, because I provided, or I prepared another file which is much longer, and which is actually a couple of minutes long, and you will recognize it when you hear it, hopefully at the end of the video. And yeah, this will not be possible to play with only single cycle playback, so we'll do something different here, and we will actually use a different function. We will call it autoplay, and we will keep the single play function so that we can call it as well, but yeah, this is good enough. And we will also put in a check for keyboard input so we can abort the play, because since it's not only 3 seconds now, it's definitely going to be good if we can stop the playback. And we need a special stop function to actually stop all the DMA stuff. The dinit stays the same, and that's, I think, good enough for now. Let's code these functions one by one, and I think the SB stop function should be the simplest, so we might wanna start with that. And we will be using the exactly this here, the raw file pointer. We will use that, and we will also use the file size here, and we will move that to the top of the file because we need this all the time. This will become global state. Global variables are bad, but we are in C here, and there's not much else that we can actually use, so I'm fine with that. So raw file and file size will be global variables now. Then we'll use SB stop, and I probably should declare it at the top as well, because we need it at some other place, probably. So, how does it work? So we write to the DSP a new command called SoundBlaster pause playback, and we will set the playing variable to 0. The playing variable is 1 while we have some stuff that is still playing, and this actually, when called from within the while loop, will also exit the while loop. When we call it at the end for safety reasons, or because we hit keyboard hit, it doesn't matter that it's here. We don't care about that. And also, to be clean, we will close the file. However, this is not necessarily important, because when we exit to DOS, the file will be closed anyway. Okay, so that's good enough, but we need to code the autoplay function. What does the autoplay function look like? So SB autoplay takes a string, takes a nice string. Let's call it file name. And how does it work? So first of all, let's make a sanity check. If the DMA buffer hasn't been allocated, so it's null, then we simply return. We don't do anything because we will crash the program otherwise. And we need to use more than one buffer, actually. We allocated the DMA buffer with twice the size that we actually need. So I think we had 32 kilobytes allocated, and every DMA buffer was 16 kilobytes, so we can double buffer. And the idea will be that we preload both buffers so that buffer 0 and buffer 1 are filled, and then we start playing buffer 0. And on the end of buffer 0, we get an interrupt from the sound blaster, while the sound blaster will continue playing to play buffer 1. And in the meantime, while it's playing buffer 1, we will read in new data into buffer 0. And when buffer 1 has ended, the autoinit will swap back to buffer 0 and play that while we load stuff into buffer 1. That's why it's called double buffering. We basically have two buffers which we take turns in playing and filling from the file. That way we don't need to load all the file into memory, but we will just load it on demand. So we need a read buffer variable. It's basically just an integer, and we start with buffer 0. And we will also set the contents of the DMA buffer to 0 and for both halves. So that's the 32 kilobytes. So this is also global state because we need to have that in the IRQ handler. And this will, I think, will just be a short integer, 16-bit, could be also be a character, doesn't matter. So let's put it here, short R buffer. Global state again. Let's go down, down, down to our autoplay function. Here it is. Okay, so now we have those two things set up. Then we can actually open the file. So the file will be opened. File name was its name. And again, we read from it in binary mode. Not a text file, it's binary. If it didn't work, well, let's be nice. Let's say file not found. %s / n for a new line, and %s will be substituted with file name, and then we return. Let's put an error here. File not found here. All right. Then we'll do file seek. So now we need to figure out how large the file is, because we need to store the file size. So we do a seek function to the beginning of the file. No, to the end of the file, sorry. So fseek takes a file pointer, which we have here, an offset, which is 0, and a relative position. We want to go to the 0th byte from the end, so the last byte. Then we can use the function ftel. Ftel tells us the position in the file. And since we seeked to the end, it will be the actual file size. So ftel on raw file will give us the file size. And then we need to rewind the file. So we just say, okay, go back to the beginning. And the beginning is seek set. It's not begin or something, it's set. I don't know why. So now we need to store a bit more state. The number of bytes that we still need to read equals the number of bytes that we need to play, because they will differ in the end after one buffer. And those are both file size at the moment. So to be read and to be played needs to be... we already have to be played here. And let's put to be read in here as well. Both are volatile because we will change them in the interrupt handler. If we don't put the volatile here, the compiler might do stupid stuff and we won't have the correct values at all places. So always, if you modify a variable in an IRQ handler, please put a volatile in front of it. Good. Now we have set up all the file variables. And just to make sure that we see everything right, we output this. And this will be a long unsigned integer, new line, and it will be to be read. Doesn't matter what we pick here because they are all the same. To be read, to be played, and file size. Then again, a command that we already know. SP set playback frequency. We had this already in the single playback function. Let's just copy that. Let's just simply copy that. Okay. 11 kilohertz is the number. And we also have to enable the speaker, otherwise we won't hear anything. Might be the DOS box is a bit more lenient, but a true SoundBlaster card will not do anything here. Then we will read the buffer. Then we will simply read the buffer 0 and we will read buffer 1. So both halves of the buffer are now filled. And I'm wondering, did we already write the read buffer function? I think we didn't. So that's the next function that we need to implement. And it will take an argument which tells us which half of the buffer will be overwritten by new data. Okay, after we've done that, if we still need to read something, which means this is a large file, then we will actually do the autoinit playback. Right, and we will do that. Autoinit playback. That is another function we will need to implement. Doesn't take any arguments, it just does the DMA setup, etc., etc. But if there's nothing to be read, that means that we actually have everything that we need. It was a small file. And we can do the single cycle playback. And that's something that we have already implemented. So that's fine. Also, no matter what we're doing, we are definitely playing by this point in time. So we'll just set this to 1. Okay. Next. Read buffer and autoinit playback are definitely missing. So we will implement those. First of all, read buffer takes a short, and what do we call this? Let me check. Yeah, let's just call this buffer. Okay, we already did this before, I think, the buffer offset. Let's put this in a constant integer so we can't change it. It's actually just simply the 0 or the 1 shifted to the left by 14 bits because this is the size of our buffer, basically. So 16 kilobytes. And if there's still something to be read, if there's nothing to be read, let's put it this. If there's nothing to be read anymore, then we just return. There's nothing to do. So we won't crash here if we call read buffer 0 and read buffer 1, and the data was only enough for one buffer. But if... Oh no, this is even... Yeah, exactly. This will be on the second call. If on the first call we already see if to be read is less than one buffer full, so that's the 16k, we will do the following. We will first initialize our current buffer with 128, and I'll tell you why. We are playing unsigned integers here, so the waveform will go from 0 to 255, but the silence, pure silence, will be only 128. That's basically the middle line without any amplitude. To get an amplitude of negative 1, basically, you will put a 0 here, and plus 1 will be 255 if you normalize the energy, basically, in the waveform. And 128 is exactly in the middle, and this is just a flat line, and it will produce no sound at all. So we first initialize the buffer with that, and then we read whatever needs to be read here. The target will be DMA buffer plus the buffer offset. We read bytes, and how many bytes we read to be read, number of bytes, from which file, raw file. So the syntax for fread is, give me a pointer where to put all the stuff, that's DMA buffer plus buff offset. What should I read? One byte at a time, and how many, and that's the number here to be read, and from which file, raw file. Simple enough, isn't it? And then, because we know this was the last buffer because it was less than 16k, we say to be read is now 0. Else we have lots more to read, so we will say we read to DMA buffer plus buff offset again, and we read a full 16k now from raw file, and we simply say to be read is to be read minus 16k, and that's already that. Now we can read DMA buffers. Simple as that. Okay, that takes care of these two lines. Oops. These two lines. Now we need to implement this function. And this function will be more complicated. It looks a lot like the single cycle playback function, with all the DMA programming, and it will be similarly complicated. If I can find my notes on that, because I can't do that purely from memory. Let's do this. So this is another void function. What do we need to do? First of all, again, very similar to what we had before. Maybe we can copy this. Let me check that I don't do any stupid stuff. Yeah, I think we can copy all this. We can copy the whole block and then change it accordingly. This way it's hopefully a bit easier to follow. Okay, let's check it. So first of all, program the DMA controller. Again, we need to write to the mask register and or the DMA channel of the SoundBlaster in there. That's the same because we're still programming the same thing. We have to reset the flip-flop. We have to write something else to the mode register. And now we will put something in here to make it better documented. We didn't do that last time. So, the mode register. In this case, works out like such. No, I'm actually wrong. This is fine. Mode register is 58. That's good. I wanted to have this. Here. No, that's good. That's good. Okay, so the mode for the autoinit is 58 plus XX, where this is, or plus DMA, SoundBlaster DMA, where in binary we have this here. And let's explain this, because we had the same thing very similarly here. So this here, these two candidates here, the 0 and the 1, are the tell the DMA chip to do block mode. Then the next two, the 0, 1 after that, tell them to do auto init. And this is where we had the difference between the auto init and the single cycle playback. And last but not least, the 1 0 tells us that this is a read operation. And so the SoundBlaster reads from memory, or not the other way around, it's not a write operation. So the single cycle playback only differed in those two bits. And you can look up the whole datasheet probably for the DMA controller, and it will tell you exactly these values and what different block modes and other things you have. But this is how we came to the value of 0x48 for single cycle playback and 0x58 for the autoinit playback mode. The rest should be the same. Let us just go through the values. Then we are writing the address, basically, the offset as we calculated it for the DMA buffer. This is still the same. This is also correct. This is the whole stupid bit shifting thing with the crazy offsets. And we need to write it bytewise. That's why we end with 0xFF here, and then we right shift to get the higher byte, and we write that to the DMA register. And then we write the page, depending on which DMA channel we have. And then we have to do the same again here with the number of bytes to be played. But this is wrong, because this time it's not to be played. This time it's some DMA block length, and we have to define that. And I think this should be, we should have used that before. This I think we didn't define yet. So let's do that. Let's do that. So the SB, no, first the DMA block length is 0x7FFF. And in a short while, we will also need the SoundBlaster block length 0x3FFF. And if you take a calculator and ask it, yo, what's... Oh, we should probably switch to hex. 0x up. This is our 32 kilobytes, which is the whole DMA block size. And guess what? Clear. 3FFF is obviously half of that. So this is what the SoundBlaster will play and after which it will trigger the interrupt. So for the DMA controller, this is just one whole thing and the SoundBlaster will trigger the IRQ every half of that, which is fine. All right, both are defined. Let's get back to our Autoinit playback. Here it is. So we write the DMA block length and we still have to do some programming on the SoundBlaster side. So, but we will write the size here. We say sbset block size, and this command we will still have to define. And we defined just now the SoundBlaster block length, which is the 16 kilobytes, and we will write that as well to the SoundBlaster. So this command we still need to define. We'll do that in a second. Okay, so the DMA controller here is now completely programmed, knows about its block length. Then we say to the SoundBlaster, you also need to know about the block length, but yours is a bit smaller, and we just write that. And then afterwards, we need to do the command for start Autoinit playback. So we've got a bunch of commands to do, because we will get a ton of errors now. Well, not a ton, but a few. So all three are undefined: pause playback, set block size, and start Autoinit playback. Here's our documentation. And let's take a look at the commands. DSP commands are on chapter 6 and onwards. So, chapter 6, DSP commands, great. So, turn on speaker is D1, turn off speaker is D3. Yeah, that sounds good. So, first of all, but we don't need that. We need to pause playback and also single cycle we had. Set block size and auto init playback. Pause DMA mode. Yeah, we want that, don't we? Yeah, we want that. Let's take this and define it for clarity's sake up here. So define SB pause playback as 0xd0. So, and what else do we need? Single cycle. Auto init here. 8-bit auto init DMA mode, digitized sound IO. Probably 1CH, I would guess. Makes sense, right? We just want to output. We don't have ADPCM encoded stuff. So that should be fine. So we take this here and also define it. S0x, what did the command here say? 0x1c. Fair enough. So now we have forgotten one, set block size. Okay, we can also define this. Let's see if we can find it in the documentation. Define S0x set block size, block transfer size 48. Build it. Success. Will it run? That's the good question. And it didn't. But to be read, 1.8 megabytes, that's fine. It doesn't quite work out as it should. So what might be the problem here? What might be the problem? Oh. Okay, yeah, we of course need to change the IQ handler. It doesn't do much useful things right now. It plays one buffer, and that's it. And you already probably recognize the sound that I'm gonna play. But of course, we're still here for the single cycle playback, where we just needed to acknowledge the IQ and that's it, and stop playing, which is of course stupid. We need to do much more here. Well, not much more, but quite a bit. So we still read the status and we acknowledge the IQ, that's fine. But that was stupid. If we are still playing, because we probably are, then we need to say, okay, we played one buffer, which is the old value minus 16384. And then please let's check if there's still something to play. If there is still something to play, we have to read stuff. So we will read into whatever our buffer is currently. That's always 0 or 1. And it will toggle every time. And we will toggle it by means of an exclusive OR. And it works like this. We XOR with 1, so it will always toggle 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 at the end of the RQ handler. So we read the buffer, and then if to be played is smaller than a whole SoundBlaster buffer, we do the toggling already here. And we will call single cycle playback because there's no autoinit necessary anymore. We will be on our last few bytes. And this is much simpler than doing the whole autoinit stuff. However, else if we have less than 32 kilobytes, so not a full DMA buffer, but a bit less, then we do stop the auto init. Because otherwise it will continue playing whatever was in the buffer, and that's ugly. That sounds terribly. Okay, so if there was something to be played, we are fine. If there was nothing to be played, we say playing is now zero and the program will stop automatically. That should do it. That's our IQ handler. If we are playing, then we are decrementing the play counter. And if there's something still left, we read the stuff. And if there's only a bit left to be played, we do single cycle playback. If there's a bit more, then we write the stop auto init so that we don't get a loop. And else, we stop entirely. And if there's enough, we go in neither of these. We just read the buffer and continue as usual. So I could write here an else block, basically, saying all is good, continue playing. So that should build. No, it doesn't, because we need this. And we need to declare this here at the top. Forward declarations are necessary if you don't take care of the order of the functions. And this is, since we only have one file, this is just fine and dandy. Okay. And we need to declare this function here. Stop auto init playback. We'll find that in a second. Define. So, stop auto init playback. DAH, okay. So 0xDA. Build all. And then run. Alright, I think this should be enough demonstration. That goes on, of course, for a couple of minutes, because you know that, that's my outro song. And yeah, that's it for the SoundBlaster PCM playback. I will put up the source code as usual. And yeah, I know the DMA programming is a bit weird, but we managed that, especially if you got the single cycle playback, you've got all the hard part, this whole stupid programming the DMA controller with the different values for the mode register. That's actually, I think, the hardest part. And writing the offset in the page, it's probably simple. Getting the offset in the page in a manner that works with the DMA controller is, of course, a bit tricky. The allocation of the DMA buffer. Everything else is more or less always the same. And now you have all the code that you need for playing small blocks or even arbitrary long blocks. With old DOS games, you don't usually have like 1.8 megabyte of music. It takes way too much space. But you would have stuff like the Pinball Fantasies games or Epic Pinball, which use mod players which mix the music in real time. And they will use this auto-init playback mode and mix the music on the fly. Basically, simple wavetable synthesis for poor people. But it sounds pretty nice. Anyway, you have all the stuff now to do amazing sounds in your programs. And I hope you enjoyed it. Please leave a like and a comment. Definitely subscribe. You can also support me on Ko-fi and Patreon if you want. Will be greatly appreciated. I can then finance this hobby a bit better. And other than that, I hope to see you soon. Goodbye.